These are deaf leads. I mean, it's a big deal for the deaf community, absolutely.
Finally, we had sign language portrayed on the screen throughout.
That the actors were authentically played by, you know, were deaf, playing deaf roles.
Die 17-jährige Ruby kann als einzige in ihrer Familie hören. Ihren tauben Eltern Jackie und Frank steht sie deswegen als Dolmetscherin zur Seite und hilft ihrem Vater und ihrem tauben Bruder Leo jeden Tag auf einem Fischerboot. Rubys größte Leidenschaft ist die Musik. Als sie dem Chor ihrer Highschool beitritt, entwickelt sie nicht nur Gefühle für ihren Duettpartner Miles, ihr Lehrer ermutigt sie auch dazu, sich an einer renommierten Musikschule zu bewerben. Ruby ist hin und her gerissen zwischen den Verpflichtungen gegenüber ihrer Familie und ihren eigenen Wünschen und Träumen. Der Filmtitel Coda ist die Abkürzung für Child of Deaf Adults, zu Deutsch Kind von tauben Erwachsenen. Beim Sundance Film Festival hat das berührende Coming-of-Age-Drama 4 Auszeichnungen bekommen. Den Grand Jury-Preis, den Zuschauerpreis, den Regiepreis und den Ensemble-Preis. Oscar-Preisträgerin Marley Matlin spielt die Mutter Jackie, Troy Kotsur den Vater Frank und Daniel Durant den Sohn Leo. Genauso wie ihre Figuren im Film sind die drei auch selbst taub. Per Videocall haben wir sie zum Interview getroffen.
It's a pleasure to meet you. The movie was really heart-touching and really great work.
Oh, thank you so much. Thank you so much. It's a pleasure to meet you as well. I'm very excited to be talking with you.
Yeah. Daniel, what attracted you the most in the story of the movie and to your character Leo?
Well, it's really cool that they had a deaf family and a coda in the family. I mean, I grew up as a deaf person, obviously, so I knew what a deaf family might look like and what codas might look like. But it was great that this was a big movie showing that particular kind of life on screen. And I was really interested in this movie because they're going to explore the family dynamic in relation to the fishing and how the family survives in this small town, you know, how these people relate to each other and know each other within the deaf family. So I thought it was really cool. I'd like people to see what this family goes through in such a in this particular environment, the fishing in a small town with the deaf culture involved. And also, I do love my character, Leo, the brother in the movie. When I read the script initially, before I auditioned, I didn't know anything about it. So I read the script and just right away, I felt like it was a perfect fit. I could easily imagine myself, you know, what that would look like, what it would take to be Leo on screen. And, you know, I felt like we were similar in so many ways, strong deaf men. Not looking for pity or sympathy, you know, whether deaf or not, you just roll ahead with your life and do what you can do. So I love that about him.
I think the thing that attracted me the most to this film and the character was, it's really actually many things, but in all honesty, the fact that it was in my language, American Sign Language, which would be used throughout the entire film, that really excited me. And the highlight of deaf culture in the film, there's so many levels that really excited me. And I was excited for people to see this, the story, a universal story, the fact that it was authentic, that the actors were authentically played by, you know, were deaf, playing deaf roles. And the fact that it's such a rich and intense story and that it happens in real life. But it's just one example of the richness of deaf culture being portrayed on the screen.
As I read the script, being able to use dirty language, ooh, I love that. And I thought people need to see what Frank could do using sign language. The other thing is, the story's compelling. And I thought, finally, we have sign language portrayed on the screen throughout. I thought, I have to play Frank. This is going to be fun. And then fishing. That was new for me. I'd never fished before. And I dove right into that character over time. I was so happy to play Frank. And I hope that the audience loves him.
Yes, I did. And in how far is this movie important for the deaf community?
It's an important, not just for the deaf community, it's for the hearing community as well. This movie shows both worlds wrapped into one. Being a coda, you have to navigate between both worlds. You have to adapt with hearing society and then with your deaf family and go back and forth. And that's what coda shows. That's why it's so important. And it's fun to share our own sense of humor that people have maybe never been exposed to or never even thought of. What a great experience.
I do think it is. You know, for example, it's a deaf family on screen and these are deaf actors, but having real deaf actors on screen is not a common thing. I mean, deaf people have shown up in small roles here and there, but this is a huge film and these are deaf leads. I mean, it's a big deal for the deaf community, absolutely. And especially in some scenes, they have such strong ASL visuals. They really go for it. And I feel like the deaf community is going to be thrilled to see that depiction, especially Troy Kotsur, who plays the father. His ASL is amazing. The deaf community is just going to fall in love with his work, I'm sure.
I can't speak for the deaf community specifically, but for those who I know personally, I know that they're going to be touched and proud for the fact that our culture is being represented. I know that... I mean, I trust that the majority of deaf people and the deaf community, when they hear about this film, will perk up and be interested and go see it, because there's going to be a lot of publicity related to this film. And we're talking about deaf culture here. It's their culture. It's their community. It's their language, their history. So I'm sure that they'll be curious, just as they were with Children of a Lesser God, because that film really excited the deaf community and people came out in droves to support the film. And I think the same thing will happen here, even more so this time, because of social media, because we have greater access, because of what's out there, the press, the chatter. I think also too, people will really be able to see for the first time, three deaf characters, three deaf actors carrying a film.
What makes you the most proud of being part of this movie?
Well, you know, I'm really proud of, I mean, actually the whole cast, not just me, right? I mean, they picked so many great actors. Marley Matlin, of course, Troy Kotsur, Emilia Jones. And I already knew Troy and Marley. We had worked together before in the past. So I was very proud about the chance to work with them. But when Emilia joined us, I mean, I will never forget the first day that we met her. I think it was at a dinner, I believe. We got together at this restaurant and it was like magic, really. We just all connected. We just had good chemistry right off the bat. Emilia was very curious and just wanted to enjoy being with us. We shared deaf culture with her. We taught her some sign language and ASL. And Emilia really enjoyed it. And she laughed and we had such a good time. We told her some ASL jokes and she really enjoyed those. And so, I mean, I'm just really proud of the cast as a whole, the way that we came together and the way we brought the energy to this film. It's really authentic. I think it's a great depiction of deafness. Emilia really got into her character so well. I mean, she learned the accents, she learned the music, she learned sign language and fishing on top of that. So, I mean, just an amazing, amazing job. So, I mean, it's wonderful. And I'm really proud of what we brought together. And also, I really want to give credit to Sean for being a great director, because she knew some sign language before we started filming. We could communicate directly with her. We didn't always need an interpreter. So we could just chat. And I think that really helped the vision. I mean, I feel really great of everything we did here. Very proud of it.
What was the biggest challenge for you during shooting the movie?
Becoming a fisherman. I grew up in the deserts of Arizona. There's no ocean there, obviously. You just have a little lake and a little stream and that's it. Like getting out there on the water and being on that environment and being far away from a city. And in, it felt like we were swaying back and forth. It was almost like we were dancing and then seeing the whales and bringing in the nets. And sorting out the fish, you had this ugly monkfish that I'd never even seen before. And everything was so heavy. We had squid that we brought in. That was a new experience. and it wasn't easy to hold them. They were so slippery. And trying to navigate all that and adapting. And then Sean talked about her vision for Frank, who was a high school dropout. He had to leave school to take over his father's fishing business as a young guy. And as his father passed, Frank took the helm for years, 40 years or so. I had to make Frank look like he was a veteran fisherman. And that was challenging for me, to make that shift from no fishing background whatsoever to a veteran fisherman.
Yes. And it was 100% real, really.
Thank you for saying that. I'm really glad that it was believable.
What does it mean to you that the movie has won 4 awards at the Sundance Film Festival?
Winning all those awards at Sundance, it meant a lot to me. It was a validation that people out there know how important this film is, that it really is something that we should pay attention to, that we need to acknowledge, and how great the movie is, the story. This is a recognition from people who make films, and they, you know, the judges were filmmakers as well, and to get that was a big deal. We really appreciated the fact that they were open-minded and they watched the film and decided that it was the best of the best.
Yes, thank you very much. The movie really touched my heart, and it was really, really great. So thank you very much to all of you.
Thank you. Have a good day.
Yeah, you too. Bye.
Ich kann doch nicht für den Rest meines Lebens bei euch bleiben.
Ich habe doch noch nie irgendwas ohne meine Familie gemacht. We'll be right back.